Hey you guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Malia Vanessa. Today I created this I don't know where I was looking, but today I created this not summer yet, but I'm already ready for it kind of look. It's kind of like an orange smoky eye with a yellow liner, some random line in my crease that I thought looked cool. I got some requests to do it, so hopefully you guys like the tutorial. If you like to see how I completed this look, then just keep watching. What's up, y'all? So in the video you're about to see, I accidentally deleted one of my clips, so it's gonna go straight into me having orange in my crease. I actually have the same makeup look I have on right now, just orange and yellow. So I'm gonna show you exactly what I did. I used my little dirty Jaclyn Hill palette here, and I used this yellow shade right here. I put that in my crease using a 2535 brush, and I just brushed it back and forth, windshield wiper motions like that. And of course, before doing shadow, I always prime my lids with my LA Pro Girl concealer, and I buff that out with my It Cosmetics Best Crease Brush. And then I went into my discontinued AF electric palette, and I used this orange shade right here. And so when the clip starts, you'll see that orange shade going on my lids. And yeah, that's about it. Sorry about that, guys. Back to the video. So I am just kind of hugging that yellow shade, and I'm doing the same exact thing I did when I first put that one. I'm just going a little bit underneath it. And then I'm gonna bring it up a little bit just so that it's an easier blend. We're just basically gonna be using 50 shades of orange. Maybe that's what I should title this. I guess you'll see what I title this, huh? I'm gonna go back in with that same yellow from the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette, and I'm gonna kind of go in and start buffing everything out so we already have a nice gradient from orange to yellow. The funny thing is, when I did this eyeshadow look, I just kind of winged it. So I don't exactly remember what I did, but I guess I'll just wing it again. I'm gonna take that same M514 brush from Morphe, and I'm gonna go into this darker orange from the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. And I'm gonna go even deeper in my crease so we start to get a nice gradient from dark to light. I'm gonna go in and deepen up my crease with this shade. And then I'm gonna start to kind of bring it to the inner and outer corners, because this is gonna transition to a halo eye. I do remember that. I do remember with a halo eye. My pores are popping right now. I don't know what's going on, but my pores are just popping. I'm gonna keep going back and forth with those same two colors until I'm satisfied with the saturation of it. You can see now it's becoming a nice blend from kind of light to dark. I'm liking the way it's looking, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut my crease now. I'm gonna use that same LA Pro Girl concealer on the back of my hand to kind of start making an empty space in the middle for my halo eye. So if you pull right from where that line in your crease is and just kind of pull it down, it kind of will do the work for you. The good thing is I'm putting glitter on, so it doesn't have to be perfect. Same, I'm just kind of going in where my natural line of my crease is when I look up, and then I'm gonna kind of pull that down. I'm gonna go back in with that same orange from my Urban Decay Electric palette, and I'm gonna start pressing that in that open space that we just created with the LA Pro Girl concealer. I'm gonna use that as kind of like the guide for where my glitter is gonna go. And now is my favorite part, the glitter. My mom got me a whole pack of all of these colors of glitter. I believe she got them from Amazon. I'm not exactly sure where, but I will leave one of my favorite glitter sites, superglitters.com, down below. I think it's $1 each for the glitter, and you can get the same exact color. This one is kind of a nice golden orangey shade,
That's gonna go right in the center of my lid. I'm gonna use the NYX Multi Masker Medium to light us. Okay, to not get this messy is less is more. We're gonna have a lot going on. We have the orange, we have the yellow. We're gonna have an eyeliner. So just a little bit of glitter goes a long way. Press it into the lid like this. There's no way to get absolutely no fallout of glitter on your face. I like to just kind of take a makeup wipe after and go back in and wipe up anything that may have fell on my face. The same thing to the other side. Just laying down that mixing medium from NYX, then directly going into that orange glitter and just patting it on my lid. So there's really no way to not get glitter on your face like this, which is why I do my eyes first when I'm doing this kind of look. I just like to take a makeup wipe and go back on the face and clean up where there's like a large pool of it, just so it doesn't show through my foundation. I don't know how it got on my mouth, but we're gonna get it off. Now you can definitely leave the look just like this. I think this is a really pretty orange smoky eye with a little bit of glitter, but I wanted to do something different. So I'm gonna take this NYX Vivid Brights in the shade Vivid Halo, and I'm gonna do a wing liner just to add a little touch of something different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. Pull up to the scene with myself I'm missing. Because this is a super bright color, I'm gonna start with the lash line, and then I'm gonna taper it real thin-like and thicken it as I get to the outer corner. I'm just gonna go right along my lash line and thicken it as I get to my outer corner, kind of like that. It's okay if it gets on your lashes. It did the first time I did this look, and it just covered when I put on mascara. So now for the wing, I like to just kind of follow the outer corner of my eye. So if you were to look up, you can see that crease. It's kind of like an invisible line. If you just follow that, it's very easy to connect the two lines. I like to start off like that, which it's not perfect, but I feel like if I start with less, it's easier for me to build up. Again, following that invisible line. And then dragging it backwards to connect to the lash line. So once I have these wings somewhat related, I'm gonna tilt my head back to see where my crease kind of lies, and then I'm gonna do another yellow line right there. Kind of like I'm cutting my crease a little bit. That's me trying to do air quotes. This part to me is the hardest part. I'm gonna flip my mirror upside down so I can get closer. So now that the tops of the eyes are done, I'm gonna finish my complexion off camera and come back to finish the rest of the eyes, and we'll have the final look. Okay, so to finish up the eyes, I'm gonna take this really sad, I need to get another one. This LA Girl Glide Pencil, I think it's just called white. It might be called something else. And I'm gonna put that in my waterline. I I do this like every day, it'll never not feel weird. So here's another one of my tricks. Instead of going and getting like every color of eyeliner for the waterline, I just kind of take my white one and then I'll put the shadow that I want on my waterline on top of the white. Yes. So I'm gonna take that same orange that I was using before from the electric palette. And I'm gonna press that right on top of that white that I just put on my waterline. I'm gonna take this pencil brush, it's an M431 from Morphe, in that same bright orange shade from the electric palette, and go right underneath that to start and smoke it out. I'm gonna go back into that deeper orange from the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm gonna put that right on top to kind of deepen it up and make it a little bit more smoky. Not least, I'm going to take that same yellow, which is kind of like the star of the show, and I'm going to put that right underneath to blend everything together. And I'm going to put that right underneath to kind of bring everything together. Take that same pencil brush in this matte white shade from the Man Eater palette from Tarte, and I'm going to put that matte white in my inner corner to brighten it up without kind of taking away from the look. I got this trick from Melissa Ashley, and I love it. Now I'm always putting like matte colors in my inner corner. I find myself doing that instead of the shimmer because it doesn't take away from the look, but it still brightens the eye. All right, and that is it for the eyes. I'm gonna come back on camera with some mascara and lashes on, and I'll show you guys the final look.